The most common flea and tick medication side effects is caused by this. And here's what you can do if it happens to your dogs or cats. Hello, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Click there to subscribe, hit the bell to sign up for notifications, and then when you click the link directly in the box below, I can send you a copy of my free book. My cat is scratching. I thought I'd just head off to my local mall, my super story place. Gonna pick up some flea and tick medication. Wearing my mask is, in my opinion, the responsible thing to do. I'm going to the pet aisle and I'm like, okay, I wonder if I can buy some flea and tick medication over the counter, topically, so much less expensive than going to the veterinarian. Ta-da, I did. And what is it that I was able to purchase? Is it safe for my animals? Well, let's have a look and see. It is a topical flea and tick medication, relatively inexpensive, over the counter. There are three treatments. One dose will kill fleas and ticks for up to 30 days. Wow, and it only costs 15 bucks. It's like a fraction of the cost of your veterinarian. This here says it's for small dogs. Should be okay for cats, right? Medium-sized printing, keep out of reach of children. This even smaller printing, do not use on cats. I don't know. If I wasn't wearing glasses, I wouldn't have known about it. If I were to apply this to Murray, he has a really serious chance of getting serious side effects, as would your own cat. And it turns out, I mean, this is the most common cause of flea and tick medication side effects. So here is the liquid stuff. It looks very similar to the stuff from the veterinary clinic, a quarter of the price. You know, they're just thinking, my cat's a small dog, right? I mean, really? Looks pretty similar to the stuff you get in the vet clinic. You know, advantage for cats. Who's gonna know? First point, you are a cat parent. Do not use tiny topical flea and tick medication meant for dogs. Ideally, you're limiting your use of this stuff, period. You're using some of those natural alternatives that are in many of the term videos. I'll link to all those below. In cats, the signs of poisoning include excessive drooling, vomiting, tremoring, hyperexcitability, seizures, difficulty breathing. If it's left untreated, it can be fatal. Our dogs can also show signs of toxicity, but this is very unlike cats. They can have a condition called paresthesia, where there's sort of tingling sensation. It's gonna cause them to maybe chewing in their paws, this excessive scratching, along with excessive drooling. So if this happens to your cat, happens to your dog, what do? You are going to get yourself your concentrated dish soap. You're gonna wash this stuff off your dog or cat. You're gonna just really lather it in, get it off of them as much as possible. It's definitely a recreation. Murray has not had any topical flea and tick medication. He's not having any side effects. But if he were, this is what I need to be doing. I'd be getting him upstairs, zooming into the bathtub or the sink downstairs. My handy dandy soap. Well, what would happen, you may wonder. Can you imagine me giving Murray a bath? I can't. Murray is not keen on the bath, as you can see. Murray? Okay. I feel it would not go well. And if your cat is seizuring, they're tremoring, then you're getting to your veterinarian, the emergency clinic, as soon as possible. Thanks so much for watching this edition of Veterinary Secrets on the most common flea and tick medication side effects. If you've yet to do so, click up there to subscribe, hit the bell to sign up for notifications, and then when you click the link directly in the box below, I can send you a copy of my free book.